Well, g'day, Tubes. How's she going? Yes, it is toque weather, believe it or not. What was it, like a week and a half ago, it was like 40 degrees out here. Now it's like 2 degrees out here. Welcome to Canada, eh? So anyways, got me kind of maybe thinking about maybe winterizing the trailer. I got the thing unhooked here. The water's unhooked. It's all drained and stuff. There's nothing else coming out of there, so that's good. And I got the two low point drains here opened. There, the hot and the cold. So we're gonna have to get inside here, I guess, and do some work inside as well. Now, I've heard a couple of things. I'll show you inside. Show you inside the panel where the pump is, which is actually just about right here. I think it is somewhere on the inside, or maybe it's over. I don't know. It's in here somewhere, I think. On the inside, of course. I've heard a couple of things. Now, there is the hose that you use inside there for pumping the antifreeze through, but I've also heard some people put it right in your fresh water. I don't kind of really know if I'd want to do that, you know, because antifreeze, water tank, now you're going to have to fill that full of water like 8 times just to flush it all out again. There is the low point drain here too, which is way, way back in behind the axle and the spring and stuff in there for that. So I guess you could just keep pouring the water in and then let it drain out, pour the water and let it drain out. But the only thing I'm concerned about is the line that goes from the tank to the pump. If you do use the hose on the inside, I'm pretty sure that line wouldn't get any antifreeze in it, as far as I know. So I'm a little bit kind of concerned about that. Now inside the box here, the garage door, they call it, apparently, is where I got my antifreeze and stuff here. So I'm gonna get one out and just have a look at her here. So that's it. Now this is antifreeze, but it's not like antifreeze like you put in your car. This is apparently non-toxic, safe for septic system, boats, recreational vehicles, seasonal homes, for use in plastic pipes only, which is what's in here. So as far as I know, you probably really wouldn't want to, but you could consume some of this, I'm guessing. It says non-toxic. But it contains a lot of ethanol, which is like an alcohol. Do not smoke, do not get knives. So instead of being like dangerous like car stuff where you should kill you, this is more like a ethanol, alcohol stuff, I guess. So alcohol won't freeze, right? So keep away from flames such as pilot light, any other objects that spark, such as an electric motor. And you're putting it through a pump. That's great. If in eyes, rinse well with water. This product is not designed as heat transfer fluid like in your car, for closed loop systems like in a radiator, or as an antifreeze for internal combustion engines. There you go. Prevent damage to drain and freshwater lines causing by freezing winter in mobile homes, recreational vehicles, boats, and seasonal homes. Warning, do not dilute any water retained remaining in the lines and drains will cause product to expand and damage water lines. Bring product to room temperature before using, so that's why I got the heat on. Direction strain water completely. Pour product into freshwater lines through the pressurization system or by removing the faucet stems. I wouldn't want to do that. For recreational vehicles, use owner's manual for further details, which this one actually doesn't have. I might be able to download one though. Add antifreeze until color is equivalent at drain points. Make sure all branch pipes are treated. For seasonal home, add 1 liter to each toilet bowl and toilet tank, which you run your toilet till it comes pink, to all sinks and traps. And that's where into the French. So it doesn't say anything about do not eat, but it does not say anything about do not eat, you know, if you know what I mean. It doesn't say you can't eat it, but it doesn't say you should eat it. So I kind of really don't know if I want to do that or not. So anyways, we'll have to maybe do some a little more research before we get out of here. All right, well, I know the first thing we're supposed to do is take the plug out, the anode rod out of the water heater back here. So we're going to let that soak a little bit because that's looking like it's probably never been out. I'm kind of willing to kind of think. Give her another little shot there just to let that soak in a little bit. While we're waiting for that, we've got our huge 1 16th. Get in there and turn that feller off, hopefully without ripping stuff apart, because the only socket I got is my great big huge feller here. I do have an adapter, reducer, whatever, but I thought, no, I'm going to use the big feller here. So we'll go inside and we'll pull the little panel off for where the pump is here. Well, she must be 66 at least in here. I've had her the furnace on all day. I've actually got, I don't know. I've been working all day, and I never got to this, and it's almost 5 o'clock already. So that kind of sucks, but sometimes that's the way she works, right? So a little LED bulb. I got my pack of whatchamacallits here. And we got to get into the little cover under here, which looks like a little wee. Well, it's a Star or a Robertson, one of them guys. So in our box of tricks, I think that one's too big. A bunch of pliers. That one's probably too small. That's not even the right one. That's too big. That one might work. I don't think really much these things. Oh, I don't think they hold on to too much anyway. So, looks like there's even one missing. Now, I don't know what kind of light there is going to be in here. Probably not a whole lot, but that is that. So, inside of here is our pump. And yeah, the light's not terrific, so I'm gonna turn on my phone light. And do believe this hose going down here is going down to our tank. That's your filler hose. And that one, this guy here, is your breather hose. They sure poured the foam into this one. Keep her good and good. So, I think what we're gonna have to do here, if I can get this thing to sit up here, here we go, is we gotta turn this one off, turn that one on. So when we put this into our jug, that should start sucking and filling up everything else. Now, back in the back here, we need to remember, I'll probably wait until I take the plug out. Oh, geez, I'm going to have to pull all these beds out here. Okay, hang on a sec here. Okay, so back here in the water here, it's pretty sweet. There's actually a light, so that's pretty handy. It's for the bed, really, but, or this, I guess. So that's our heater. So right now, there's the cold coming in the bottom and the hot going out the top. So you can see the cold blue, I'm presuming, is going in the bottom. And the hot up here is going to the hot everywhere. So what we want to do, from what I remember Buddy telling me, we need to turn off that, and then turn on this. So what's going to happen is we're going to pump antifreeze into the cold line from the pump. It's going to pump into here and around and then go out to all the hot areas where the hot water will go, and it's going to bypass, because it's going to come into this fitting here but not go past into the heater, vice versa, right? Those two are shut off now. So
Not too sure if I should do that or open that thing first, let it drain out. Probably go try that next. And we might need a, I guess it'll gloop, gloop, gloop until it's empty anyways. I was thinking of leaving one of these open and then it would suck a bit of air from, you know, if you leave a tap open, it would go better. But I guess we'll just leave her like that for now. And we'll go see if we can get that plug out. All right. That should give us a fair good leverage with this fella on here. Listen to it. It's like super awesome. So I don't know how tight this will be. I'll just go real easy. Oh, not too bad. A little bit of lube might have helped there. Maybe, maybe not. I'm curious to see how this anode rod is looking though. As in old one to new one. Hang on a second. I'll grab the new one first. So that's the new one. Now what the point of these are is the hardness and crap and stuff in the water is supposed to eat this rod instead of eating the inside of your tank. That's the theory. So we'll see how bad this one looks when we pull her out here. If this one's even ever been out in its entire life, oh boy. Oh man. It's probably still good, but this one sure looks a lot better. Wow, that's really pitted. Let's have a good look at that there. It looks like a freaking, I don't know. That's quite a difference, so just want to try this one in here. Yeah, I guess it'll fit. So, it's really rotted up here, really bad up here. Wowee. Well, that's interesting, but nothing come out, so that's good. That means my low point drains are working nice, except there's a lot of crap in here that should really get flushed out. I guess I could take my hose and fire it in there. Everything's shut off. Maybe that would be an idea. Maybe I'll do that. Hang on a sec. Yeah, I don't know if this is a good idea or not, but not much come out. I want you to get my finger stuck in here now. That'd be awesome, wouldn't it? I don't see a whole lot coming out. I'll let that drain out again, yeah. You need to get in there with like a real pressure-y thing. Oh, I don't know. I might actually maybe even replace this whole entire heater sometime here. It's, I don't know. It's probably fine, but just looking at it, it's like, wow, you guys never took care of this, did you, at all? Like, Garen pretty much teed that is the original rod that was in there, and it's just deteriorating like crazy, I would say. So, we might have to, I don't know, that's craziness. Now, while we're back here, I'm gonna let it sit open a little longer, but we're supposed to close our low point drains too. On the very back bottom corner here, there's a couple drains, hot and cold. Okay, so funny enough in here, you can kind of feel where the screw went in, but then it drops down like a finger's depth. But I guess the tank area in there is large enough that if it was full of water, yeah, it would freeze and split, but with a little bit of water in there, they even say on the tanks too, that's not a big concern because this is gonna freeze to a certain point and it's gonna expand a little in the tank, but it's not enough to damage anything, right? So, hopefully. Come on, you turd. Okay, so underneath here, we wanna close our low point drains. I don't believe there's anything spewing out of them now. So we'll close that one, and we should be good to put the hose in the pump and fire it up. Now we got a couple of little things too. I was reading, and a lot of people, they don't do their little piece of hose from the system to the city water connection here. So when it's pressurized, they say just turn the pump off, pressure it, turn the pump off, you know, hold your hand over, and then push the little valve in here, and it'll
It'll come out that line. So I'm like, oh, I never even thought of that.
But also as well in here, we've got the little shower, outdoor shower that I'll need done too. So we'll get that out. That's all off right now. I just cleaned that too. Look how dirty it is already. Oh. But we'll do that. And when we're done, my water thing can go in here. And yeah, I think we're good to go in and pressurize. Everything is good. I think we should be good. I gotta do that vent hood soon too. I got the bottom screws out of it, but I didn't get time to finish it, so. Okay, let's get inside. See if we can spew a bit of this yummy looking stuff out. I'll get one jug here. I don't think I'm gonna need that many jugs, but you never know, right? I'm gonna open that to get a bit more light too. I was doing a bit of reading on this water heater. I'm really contemplating between going replacing that this one with a new one or one that's water on demand. I'm not too sure what I want to do yet. Okay, so let's see. We'll put these little screws up so we don't lose them. This stuff's super awesome. Oh, it smells good. And I left my phone going there the whole entire time. So that should be good to suck. That, I'm gonna take this off. And we'll turn the pump on here. And I gotta make sure these are all off so it'll pressurize. That's good, that's good. That's good. That's good. I had all these open trying to drain water out. That's good, that's good. Remember to do your shower thing too, and your toilet. Nothing in the tank right now, so. Okay, oh, sorry, we gotta turn the pump on in here. So, hopefully this works. Ooh, the level's going down. That's good. I heard some awful lots of trickling back here, which I didn't. Didn't particularly like the sound of too much, but now if we turn on. They say to get it down in your pee traps quite a bit too. I'm actually gonna turn this off now. That's pretty awesome. I gotta show you my new bed after too. We got some bedding. You should see some water come out. See, that water would have froze. Until the pink comes out. Let that run a second or two. That one's good. See, if you don't do that, that would have froze. Okay, I'm going to say that one's good. It's funny, that one didn't have much come out of it, but... Now, I don't know what to do about the crap in the sink there. I guess you'd run a pail of water down it. And the jug is still pretty good. That's good. Stuff smells awesome, let me tell you. Ooh, there's a lot of water in that one. There we go. That's good, that's good. Okay, so we got that water source is done. This water source is done. That water source is done. The bathtub is done. It's just outside of the outdoor shower. I think that should be winterized.
didn't hardly use a whole jug. That's pretty awesome. See here now. I'll just let that drain out there and kill the grass. That'd be awesome. Now this one here, if you do that now, it'll go whoosh all over you. So you kind of don't really want to do that. You want to, not want to do that. You should actually probably have a hose, but it's actually supposed to, water pressure on this side is supposed to push that valve open. It's actually leaking out a bit on its own, I think. That's not good. Oh. I don't know if I can push that or not. Nope. I'm going to have to bleed a little bit off of there and then be able to push her. So I'll turn the pump off so it doesn't come back on. Actually, if I open that shower and then pushed it, it probably would go. Okay, so that's good, that's good. I'm not doing too bad there, almost a whole jug. Turn the pump off. Good. And I don't know if I'll be able to get this or not here with my hand. Probably if I stuff my screwdriver in. I don't know, maybe I'll put you guys way up over here so you're guaranteed not to get a splash. And I'll hit her with my end of my screwdriver here. Okay, I think that should do her. Wow, that stuff really doesn't take long to dry up. Gone. So, okay, let's just go over this again. So that one's the last one. We did these. This we bypassed and did inside. That's good. There's nothing else, water around here. I'm sure bringing lots of dirt in. I don't like that, but anyways. I guess we can just wipe the sinks out here because I don't really want the coloring of this stuff on here. But that should work pretty good. P-traps are good and full. I'm not sure if I should leave the taps open or not. I'm going to have to read on that. I'm not sure. They leave the tap shut or leave them open. That's good. Guess that's okay. That's good. We'll turn the light off. Put that somewhere now because it's going to crap all over it. And now what do I do with it? Right there, maybe. I think everything should be good in here. Yep, you can see the stuff even there in the lines. The pink and the white stuff there. That's kind of cool. That's good. I think we got her. That wasn't really too bad at all. I thought it was going to be a lot more involved than that, but it wasn't really too bad at all. So I guess that should about do it. I don't think there would be anything else that we need to do. The fridges I'll probably leave just open. I do have somewhere here I put all this thing here. It's supposed to trap moisture and stuff. We'll probably get it going in here, you know, keep the moisture levels hopefully down. I guess I can put this stupid piece of trim keeps popping off on me here. I even got some stuff under there and it's never worked. It sort of sticks it down, but then it pops off again. I guess I can put this sort of back together for now. Yeah. We better get this off or I'll forget. So I've slept on this bed once. I think it wasn't too bad. With the second mattresses, like we got an extra mattress. So this is the original crappy one that was in it. And they weren't very comfortable, so we went and got these 3-inch thick ones. I just had to shave the one bottom. It wasn't too bad. Oh man, I just hit the thing, the flap thing on my viewfinder thing here, and had the thing in my teeth there, holding there while I was doing this, and the thing flipped shut and slapped me on the lip. It kind of sucked. Okay. That'll need some fixing, of course, but show you our sweet bed in here now. We got a new cover dewy for the top of the foam, new foamy stuff, and I come with sheets and stuff, but we already had sheets on it, so I didn't use them. But new pillows and stuff, and it's, you know, pretty awesome. So I haven't actually used it yet. Might have to do that some night. I have no water now though. It's all shut off. But anyways, this has got to go back in the freezer. And I still got the propane on, but I might leave it on for now. I guess this can get... Oh yeah, one thing the guy I was watching too, he was saying... I got one other thing I want to check in here. Oh no, that should be fine. Should run through and then up the pump and then through the plumbing. The only thing I'm concerned about is, now what about the line that goes here and then down into your tank? Would there not be water in that? Maybe not now, because I left these open and I've had the drains open and everything. Maybe that would back and nothing left in there. I don't know if you can see it, but it's the line here that goes back to your tank. You're holding water, fresh water tank. I mean, is there not stuff in that? Like, I don't really want to open it and then pump crap into there, but I guess I could give it a little shot, but then you're going to have some of that, this crap in your fresh tank, and I kind of really don't want that. But, I mean, hopefully it's opened now, and, you know, should be good, but I guess, that's not good. This stuff dilutes pretty good, so, you know, I guess you could just open this. Close that one again. Come on, you turd, you open up fine. What's up with that? And maybe some of that'll kind of trickle down that line and fix it. But how did that screw get in there? Okay, so I think that should be good, unless you guys had any more ideas of winterizing stuff, but I think I got pretty darn near everything anyways. Should pretty much get it. I better get that cleaned up. And all we got is one of these. Floor probably needs cleaned anyways, but okay, I guess we'll put the cover back on and we should be good. Alrighty, so I guess we're good for that. Unless you guys have any other, you know, things I haven't done that I need to do with it. Everything's been pumped everywhere, so... smells good. It smells like... sort of like bubble gum. I don't know, they shouldn't make that stuff smell good, because now I want to have a swig and see if it tastes like Kool-Aid or some kind of drink stuff, you know? Don't think that's a good idea, but anyways... yeah, so that's good. So yeah, I was just looking at the water heaters here. This thing's a Suburban water heater.
They'd have the different models. I think the one I found out was we had the 6 gallon here, gas electric. I think that's the one we've got from the plate. Anyways, I think that's the one I found I had, if I can remember right. It's been a while since I looked at this silly book here, but they of course don't tell you any prices on these things, so I bet you there's probably, you know, $700-$800 water heater anyways. But I don't know, it's either that or I was thinking of going with the hot water on demands. There's the anode rods too. Pretty much what we got outside there. I gotta bring that back in too. Pretty much, yeah, I wanna replace it, but I don't know whether I want to go with the one of these again where you run out of water in like 4 minutes of a shower, or you get the one that's probably going to burn a heck of a lot more propane, but you got hot water on demand kind of thing. You want hot water, she just keeps going until, you know, until the propane runs out, basically. So it's just kind of, come on, I got no grips on my fingers from that stuff. It's all electric water heaters. I don't know where the hot water on demand ones are. It's probably going to be a different size hole as well, so you'd have to carve a new bigger or something smaller, whatever, hole in the side of the trailer. There's furnaces now, so I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Don't know what to say. Suburban water heaters or Atwood water heaters. There's the Atwood water heaters here. So they're a little more different. They don't have that big anode rod in them. They just have a drainer cock valve thingy on the bottom there. Pet cock valve thingy, I guess they call them. Washer and dryers. Don't think I need to worry so much about that. But, there's an on-demand water heater. Provides continuous hot water experience. A 45 and 50,000 BTU cutout min max. 12.5 by 16 wide. By 12.5 by 16. By 16 inch minimum. Adapter plate required for openings. Heights above 13. Now, this one here, does it tell me what size? Of course not. I guess you'd have to measure it. They don't tell me what size it is. Oh, that sucks. But I don't know. I kind of wouldn't mind going with one of them. But very expensive. Very, very expensive for one of them. But I don't know. This one's not looking kind of the super greatest, but. Mixed feelings about those. So I asked the people actually at this place here, a buddy of mine went to there, McFalls of Harrison, quite a big place there, and I asked her, do you guys sell hot water heaters? Do you sell the on-demand, or, you know, what do they call them? Oh my goodness. On-demand water heaters, yeah. And she's like, oh yeah, we install them, we also remove them. I'm like, oh. Okay, she's like, yeah, a lot of people didn't like them. I'm like, oh, okay. She never said why. She's just a front desk lady, right? So she wouldn't, you know, really know. But I'm like, oh, why would people, I wonder why they'd have such a problem with them, you know? You think it could be pretty awesome. So, yeah, they couldn't really tell me why they were removing them. They says, oh, yeah, the people went back to the other ones. I'm like, why would you? I mean, I don't know. It seems like such a waste to have 6 gallons of hot water sitting there, okay? So say I wanted hot water, hook my thing up, runs for like 20 minutes, heating the water up, okay. You use that water up, turns on again to heat it up. You know, if you run it right out, it's gotta run for another 20 minutes. Well, if you want hot water, you turn the other thing on, so you turn it off, it shuts off. It doesn't run for like another 25 minutes after. I don't know, I think it would be more economical on propane, but maybe it's not. I don't know, like I can't say I never had one, right? So. But at my sister's house in Halifax, they've got a system like that, and I mean, it seems to work fine for, you know, hot water. There's hot water there when you need it, right? So it's not like you gotta heat a thing all the time, and it's, you know, gotta keep that warm. And I don't know, I just not liking the idea of that. But yeah, I don't know what to say about it, but. Maybe these things, if you're using too much hot water too fast, it doesn't keep up.
maybe that's the problem with them. They never said. So I don't know if you guys have an idea or two on that, you know, the tankless versus the tanked water heaters. Let me know. And we'll figure something out. But, I mean, this one even says 18 to 20 gallon per hour quick recovery water heaters. So I don't know, like 8 to 20 gallon per hour, that's not really a whole lot, I guess. But as far as I know, these are, you know, you want it, she makes sure until you run out of propane, it doesn't, like, you know, get all cool all of a sudden and then it runs out. I don't know. Maybe it does too. Maybe they're just not a big enough heater from a unit for that. I don't know. But yeah, that's that. So another thing I wanted to ask you guys a little bit about was some of these drone helicopter videos I've been posting up here. A lot of you don't seem to like them for some reason. I don't know why. I kind of wish you would, the ones that are putting all these sums down, that you'd chime in a bit and let me know what I can do to make it better. I thought it'd be freaking awesome, you know. You guys could finally see the actual place from, like, you know, a couple of miles above or something, but I'm just looking it up here. I'm just curious to why it's not sort of going over too well, you know. I kind of thought, well, you guys would probably really enjoy flying around, you know, and looking around the land and stuff, and, you know, maybe the town a bit, and then I want to fly it over the lake and, you know, do some stuff out there, and, you know, we could look at the new bridges and stuff and, you know, go down and buzz people. No, I wouldn't do that, but some birds out there, I do want to do that too. Come on, you thing, load up, hurry up. But honestly, yeah, like, you know, there's a lot of thumbs up on it, but holy cow, I've never taken such a thumbs down kicking in my butt for that forever. So I don't know what it is, but I could maybe understand mixing the music with it. But the only thing is, that thing doesn't record sound. So I've got to pretty much throw my GoPro on myself, and then you can hear sound and me talking and see what the camera's seeing on the drone. But it doesn't record sound, I guess, because all you'd hear is wind noise and the whole time. So really, would you want to hear that in the video, right? So I post music to it, to that one. But the one I did last night when I was outside at nighttime, I had my GoPro in my pocket and my little lapel mic so I could talk to it, right? So there's a video there too of my pocket, but then just mostly the audio of me talking. But okay, so the first video we posted, called The Box, when we first got it there. Now I must say, this is quite impressive. There's 565 thumbs up, that's good, but 28 thumbs down. Normally I don't get that many thumbs down. You know, I'm 10 to 15, maybe, you guys, I really don't like anything I do for any of my video stuff that always gives me a thumb down. Really wish you'd tell me why you give it a thumbs down, and I can maybe accommodate stuff to maybe please you. I know I'm not going to be able to please everybody. It's always going to be someone that's not going to like something. But really, it's not like I'm out killing kittens or something. Like, I could see a thumbs down on that. But, I mean, why is so many thumbs down? Like, I just really don't understand, you know. That's why I want you guys to tell me, that are giving me the thumbs down, what is that you're giving me the thumbs down about? Instead of just thumbing down and whatever, do it for me, and then I can try to adjust, okay? It's really got me stressed out a little bit on this, because, like, I don't know what I'm doing wrong that you guys aren't liking, that I could maybe change and make better. Okay, so the second video was buzzing the concrete guys and some flying around. That was a 25-minute video. That was actually two batteries worth, too. 339 up, thank you for that, but 49 down. I mean, okay. Kind of figured you'd like that video too, but apparently that didn't go over. Now that one had music too, I think. And the 200 meter altitude, Orangeville at night, I think I posted that last night, so that would have been October 1st. 250 thumbs up and 35 down. All three of those videos have just freaking hammered the thumbs down for some reason, and I would just like to know why. So if you guys that are thumbing these down could just post something to help me, you know, figure out what it is that you'd rather see, we'll do that, you know. So yeah, And the Mad Max video did not go over too well, so I don't know if we'll be playing too much Mad Max. Holy crap, I got 40 thumbs down on that. You know, 132 up, but, you know, if you're going to all thumbs that down, there's no point in me even bothering. So, I mean, it's a pretty sweet game. I don't know why you guys wouldn't want to see more gameplay of it, but anyways, it's up to you. But yeah, everything else is like 14, 8, 6 thumbs down. Like, I don't know, it's just like, you know, sure. That's just, you know, the normal videos, like the mower, the... the air show we went to, painting the vent pipe install, the rental of the Kubota, it got 25 thumbs down. I don't know why he just didn't like that too much, but, you know, what the heck, we're having fun, like, don't take it so seriously, you know, like, holy cow, it's just, you know, I rented that machine just to have a bit of fun with, show you guys something different, you know, I can't keep doing the same grind of stuff all the time, you know, like I have no projects to weld right now, so I'm not doing any of that. Obviously, I haven't seen any welding project, right? I got nothing I need to get built, so I have no welding project. So, Farm Sim Saturdays always seem to do pretty good, which I do have one coming up for you for tomorrow. But I don't know, I just kind of wish these guys or these ones that are always summing things down, let me know what's wrong. Like, I can try my best to accommodate. You know, and if you really, really, really have a problem, then don't watch. That's as simple. Don't click on the video. I'd rather you not watch it than thumbs it down. It would make my life a lot more, you know, less insane. Wondering what I can change to make it better for everybody. No, I know I'm not going to please everybody, but I'm trying my hardest, you know, but it's just not working. So, but everybody's to their own opinion. I understand that, but let me know why. That's all I'm asking. Let me know why, what I can do to change, what I can, you know, if you want me to jump off a cliff, if that would solve all your problems, so be it. I'm not jumping off a cliff though, so you can just not watch. How about that? But man, I don't know. Like it's starting to get to me kind of a little bit, you know, as in, why am I bothering to do this? You know, like I like making videos and content for you guys, but if you're always going to be thumbing trapped down without even letting me know why, then there's no point in me doing it, you know? Like it's just like, I don't know, I'm just looking through here and what was that one? Well, we got this trailer. 24 thumbs down on that, but 730 up, so a lot of you like that one, but there was a lot that said, new. So I don't know. You guys always seem to hammer you with the thumbs down whenever I buy something for us, the family, or myself, or, you know, renting a little tractor to mess around with. Like, what the heck? Why would you thumbs down that? I just don't understand. So, anyways, if you can do that for me, if you're the ones, one of the ones, or some of the ones that are always summing everything down to me, just let me know why. I'll try my best to accommodate, and if not, then sorry, I can't do any better. So, but I mean, honestly, if it keeps continuing like this, like, I love making videos and stuff for you guys. It does take a lot of time. It takes a lot of, you know, computer time, filming time as I'm doing right now. Computer time rendering it, uploading it, you know, processing YouTube, getting everything ready on there. It takes a lot of time, but, you know, I like doing it, so I'm still doing it. But, you know, if they keep kind of going the way things are going, then that might be it. Like, you know, it's fun, but it's not that fun. Like, it's still a lot of work. I put a lot of hours into this for putting up content for you guys. And, you know, if you're thumbing down everything like that, it's kind of like, you know, it doesn't make any sense. Like, why bother? You know? So, I don't know. If you want to comment, if you're one of the thumbs down or the thumbs down all the time, if you want to comment, just leave it on the bottom there and I'll look at it and whatever. I mean, if you're going to be totally rude and stupid about it, then you'll be just, I'll just delete that because I don't need to see that on my channel. So, like if you're going to tell me where to go and how to get there and, you know, don't come back kind of thing, well, that's not going to stay. I need constructive comments of how to make it better, not freaking idiots saying, whoa, why don't you just go shoot yourself in the foot or something? I don't need to hear stuff like that. But anyways, that's my rant for today. We do have a Farm Sim Saturday coming up for you tomorrow. Found a pretty sweet couple of mods for that one, so you guys will probably enjoy that. Yeah, it was really, really cool mod actually from ls2015.com. It's where I get all my stuff from. I don't go anywhere else to look for stuff because actually I don't have time. I just use this one site and go from there. So But anyways, that's it for today. Let me know too if there's anything else you think I need to do for winterizing on this thing. I think I pretty well got everything. Yeah, I think that should be mostly about it. It was a busy week this week, so holy cow, that's why I didn't get a whole lot of content up for you. Just a couple of flights, and then that was about it. This week's been kind of one of them weeks that was quiet for a while there. I kind of enjoyed it, and I was getting more stuff for you, right? But then now it's taken right off again, and even by next week already, holy friggin' crap, it's only Friday this week, and I've already got, hang on. Next week I've got 4 burials already for next week, and this is only Friday of this week. Like, holy crap! And that hasn't even started next week yet, and then I'll probably have more by next week. So, but anyways, that's it for me today. Just let me know on that stuff we just talked about, and like I say, if you leave rude comments, I don't put up with that crap. I'll just scrap that and go from there. So anyways, have a good night. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the Farm Sim Saturday tomorrow. Wasn't a huge long one. And tomorrow I am actually going to the Dufferin... what's it called? Dufferin County... hang on a second. I'm going to look it up. Okay, it's the Dufferin Town and Country Farm Tour. And I don't give you exactly where you're going yet, but... there's, I think, 4, sometimes 5 different farms you'll go to. I know one of them's a dairy farm. I can't remember the rest of them, though. They say down here you can download your passport or go pick it up here. Download and print your passport. Maybe it will on the PC, but not on this thing. So you get your passport, and then it gives you the route and stuff. They'll be out actually hammering in signs probably now for it, for the route. So you just have to bring in a non-perishable food for the food bank donation, which is nice. And there's about 4 or 5 stops, so we're going to probably do that tomorrow. I'll take the camera with me, and hopefully it's good, because last year it totally was not good, and I don't think I even posted anything on it, because it was just horrible. It wasn't even farms you stopped at. It was like, come look at my knitting store, or something like that, right? It really sucked. Oh, it was horrible. So I didn't film hardly anything. There was one I was all excited about, because it was this dairy, so we go to the dairy. You know, you'd see the milk production and how they milk cows and stuff and all that. And you get there and it's like, come look at our store. And that was it. I'm like, really? Where's your operation? We want to see that. We don't really so much care about your, like, $8.99 a liter natural milk. Holy crap. But anyways, that was horrible that last year. So hopefully this year is better. So I'll probably film that for you and then probably get that posted maybe on Sunday-ish and around there, hopefully. And we'll go from there. But next week, I cannot tell you what's going on yet. I'm pretty sure by next week, depending on the weather, I'm going to probably be into leaves, picking up and bagging, and in the trailer thing guy here. Out there, see him? Right there. Pretty heavy. So actually, yesterday I was out. Got the trailer pretty much full. I'm like, oh, maybe I'll go dump it. And I'm like, oh, no, I'll do the stuff on the front lawn here first at the house. Got all that bagged into it. Looking inside, I still had room. I'm like, this thing goes for freaking ever. It's awesome. So, yeah, we finally went and dumped. And, oh, man, that bale, it pretty much come out as a whole bale. And it was hard-packed stuff. It was awesome. So that's going to work super awesome when the leaves are actually down. This is just the preliminary early guys, you know. When the real leaves come down, it'll fill up pretty quick. So anyways, that is it for today. We will catch you tomorrow for Farm Sim Saturday, and hopefully Sunday for the farm tour we did on Saturday tomorrow. So anyways, have a good night. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you through the weekend here.